Welcome and thank you for being here today. Today we ask the Creator to bless our minds, our hearts, and our words so that we may speak good medicine into the world today. We give thanks to the tribal nations whose land we stand on today. We give thanks to the Mattaponi, to the Pamunkey, to the Chickahominy, to the Rappahannock, to the Upper Mattaponi, to the Nansemond, to the Nottoway, to the Monacan, and to the Potawatomi, and all of the ancestors of the Tidewater peoples whose without their foresight and stewardship we would not be here today. Today, Pope Francis will make remarks in the Mid-Atlantic region. I would like to call to your attention content released in a recent papal encyclical on the environment. His Holiness has highlighted indigenous peoples' cultural rights and land rights as major factors, both underlying the issues and in seeking solutions to the world's most pressing environmental concerns. His Holiness wrote, "Many intensive forms of environmental exploitation and degradation not only exhaust the resources which provide local communities with their livelihood, but also undo the social structures which for a long time shaped cultural identity and their sense of meaning of life and community. The disappearance of a culture can be just as serious or even more serious than the disappearance of a species, a plant, or animal. The imposition of a dominant lifestyle linked to a single form of production can be just as harmful as the altering of ecosystems. In this sense, it is essential to show special care for indigenous communities and their cultural traditions. They are not merely one minority among others, but should be the principal dialogue partners, especially when large projects affecting their land and waters are proposed. For them, land and water is not a commodity, but a gift from God and from their ancestors who rest there, a sacred space with which they need to interact if they are to maintain their identity and values. When they remain on their land and have access to the water, sea, and ocean, they themselves care for it best." These are the words of His Holiness Pope Francis. I leave you with his words as he visits America today, and I charge you to consider his counsel in our work now and in the future. Indigenous nations should be your principal dialogue partners. So we give thanks. Thanks to the Tidewater peoples and the tribal nations who welcome us to their shores today. We give thanks to the four-legged. We give thanks to the two-legged, the finned, the furred, and winged ones. All my relations, we give thanks. Tabunamish. I thank you for allowing me to give this blessing, and I thank the Tidewater peoples for allowing me, from a nation not from this region of Norfolk, Virginia, to be here and to say these words in blessing our meeting today. With that, I also want to recognize another tribal leader who is in the room today, Chief Coker, who is the principal chief of the Lenape Indian Tribe of Delaware. He also serves as the chair of the Confederation of Nanticoke Lenape Tribes, Delaware Bay. That confederation includes the Lenape Indian Tribe of Delaware, the Nanticoke and Lenape Tribal Nation, and the Nanticoke Indian Tribe. And I encourage you to go and speak with Chief Coker today. We really are welcoming him and thankful that he is able to join us for today's session. So, thank you, Tabunamish.